Welcome to Microsoft Unboxed. I'm one of your hosts, Sonia Dara, and I'm joined by my colleague, Colleen O'Brien.
Hey, world.
We are just two best friends who come together every week to share great technology stories coming out of Microsoft and talking about the awesome people behind each one of those awesome stories. That was a lot of awesomes. We each have a secret story that we'll share with one another. So the first time I'm hearing Colleen's story is literally on air and vice versa. Today's topic is, you ready? Actual drum roll. AI for Earth. Nature here is just absolutely amazing. I know in Atlanta where I grew up, it wasn't allowed of that you could like go outdoorsing.
Yeah, you're doing a lot of running outside, a lot of camping, a lot of hiking. I'm walking to the bus in the morning.
What's the weirdest thing you've ever done in the outdoors?
For some reason, I can't stop thinking about like picnicking or like watching a movie outside.
That's just physically being outside. I guess I'm thinking in the woods, in the forest. I think the weirdest thing that happened is I became a self-sufficient backpacker. I don't know about you, but I've gotten to go check out Iceland and Patagonia and getting to actually walk on glaciers.
Yeah. To be honest, I'm more of a city girl. When I got my sleeping bag, my mom was like, who are you? So I wish I could say like hunting for mushrooms or—
I have done that.
Really?
A friend of my boyfriend's is a mushroom forager. And so we went down near Olympia, got like 8 different types of mushrooms. Of course we didn't eat any of them because we didn't trust him. But
cool. You didn't trust this person?
No, we trusted him. So we went and bought store-bought mushrooms afterwards and made dinner.
Sorry for not having more outdoors.
So to get back on topic a little bit, where we're talking about AI for Earth, it's a program actually at Microsoft where we are offering grants to programs that are focused on bettering the Earth. So we'll give them cloud computing opportunities and tools that basically help solve these global environmental challenges. There's 4 areas of focus for projects that you can apply for. So the first area of focus is agriculture. How can we create more food with lower environmental impact? How can we create climate resilient agriculture, things that actually survive in the changing climate? The second area of focus is biodiversity, habitat protection and restoration, pollution control. Third area of focus is climate change, showing how AI can help with climate resilience, extreme weather modeling. Imagine if you can actually predict and know where droughts or extreme cold drops or anything like that, which leads to the fourth area, which is water. So in the next 2 decades, demand for fresh water will actually outpace the supply, which is really concerning.
It is.
So AI can help with water supply, quality, sanitation, efficiency, and obviously the oceans. How can we make healthier oceans? Programs or projects that are focused on these can apply for a grant. Some of the latest recipients for the grants, one is like tracking Antarctic penguin populations.
Ooh. Right?
Yeah, they had like different IoT devices and like how they would actually track
migrations. It's like Internet of Penguins instead of Internet of Things.
So another one is understanding melting glaciers, which is something very near and dear for me because I've gotten to see so many glaciers around the world. And 2 that I know that Microsoft is helping in-house with right now is Project Premonition. It's basically helping them track outbreaks before they happen. Using drone traps again to gather mosquitoes, and basically they're monitoring the infectious diseases on site.
So they'll be the first to know about the zombie outbreak?
Yes, they'll be the first ones to know and hopefully prevent it. There is this Microsoft FarmBeats program. So beets as in like beets and not beets as in the vegetable. They're using drones to go over all the different farmland. So instead of manually having to walk, it actually sends data from ground-based sensors, tractors, cameras to a camera that's basically sitting on the farm using TV white space. TV white space is kind of this in-between for where Wi-Fi might not be readily available and then radio signals. So basically using Azure IoT Edge, which delivers cloud intelligence locally, they are able to send all this data to the cloud.
I have met Ranveer Chandra, who is the creator of FarmBeats. He grew up going to India during the summer and participating in the agriculture, and he hated it. How hot it was, how much work there was. He took that experience, learned a ton about computer science, and became a researcher and started figuring out how do we make this a better situation. One of my favorite use cases for FarmBeats is how they're tracking livestock. So they have this camera in a barn of sorts and they're using artificial intelligence to see how the cows are moving into the...
These are happy cows?
Yeah. He always makes a joke because that drone footage will show where the cows are pooping and that he's doing deep learning on cow poop.
Smells great.
We're gonna talk about this nonprofit called WildMe, this initiative that brings AI and citizen scientists together to fight extinction.
Oh, that's awesome.
They are using AI and cloud technology to identify animal species that are on the verge of extinction, and then using computer vision and deep learning to power Wildbook, Facebook for animals.
What?
Photos get uploaded to this system. An algorithm identifies not only the species, but like the individual animal.
What?
Yeah.
Like each one has a name, like Harriet the bobcat?
That's correct. Like Willie the whale. The system can recognize distinctive markings on the animal.
Wow.
So you can see how they are breeding, what their social structures might be like. Like if there are two animals who are friends and they're like spending a lot of time
together. So they can change their status to being like in a relationship on Wildbook.
It's also indicative of climate change. Like it is tracking their migration patterns, that sort of thing.
Is it accessible to the public or like what is it?
Yeah, citizen scientists are encouraged to upload photos from any animals that they see in the wild. One of the issues with social media culture is that
we're just gonna talk about one today
is that we're only uploading the best photos of an animal that we have maybe seen in the wild. This artificial intelligence requires that they have a lot of data to assess. Maybe you're only posting your coolest photo on Instagram, but head over to Wildbook and upload all of the photos because they need that information to do accurate assessments of how animals are moving around, living,
data points, the better.
Interacting with each other. This system is also taking a look at YouTube, where we are now.
Here.
They had a whale shark YouTube scanner that went through all the videos that had a tag for whale shark, cataloging that information as well. The reason why Wildbook is so important is it condenses all of this work that would take a human years to conduct into a matter of weeks.
How we stalk maybe an ex, that they can stalk their prey.
Ooh.
Your muscles are looking particularly pretty today.
Like during mating season?
Everyone's peacocking and literally the peacocks are like, ah. AI for Earth. It's pretty awesome. For anyone who might have a project and looking for funding, absolutely apply online. Are you ready for our favorite segment of our show?
Yes.
Outside the box. What this is a box full of questions that you guys have all been submitting. They're random questions. We don't know what they are. If we can get 30 seconds on the clock back there, please. What is the weirdest thing you've ever eaten for breakfast that is not a breakfast food?
The weirdest thing that I've ever eaten for breakfast, fried rice.
I normally have ramen or pho.
Ooh, I love that. I wish I could say like bugs or something, but I don't eat a lot of weird stuff.
I think we've established that you're not the outdoorsy woman between the two. It's for
okay.
Bugs. No offense. She's stink eyeing me.
Sonia, are you ready for this?
Okay, I am ready.
If you could have any celebrity be your best friend.
Emma Stone.
Woo, you didn't even need to think about it. Why?
She's just super cool and likable. I don't know, they're just like our age and cool and down to earth.
What's your favorite Emma Stone movie?
Easy A. Still, it's like her first one.
It's a really good movie.
It's so funny. She goes, I got a pocket, I got a pocket. I got a pocket full of sunshine. Like, that's why I was like, I want to be her friend. But then I also really like La La Land. Sorry, I only liked it after the last 5 minutes of the movie.
You stuck with it.
I did.
That's a controversial fave.
Yeah.
La La Land.
But it's not my favorite. Easy A is definitely my favorite.
Good answer. All right, we're done.
Was that awkward? Make sure you submit questions for our Outside the Box segment to the email address below, or you can comment.
And please remember to subscribe to our channel to get the latest episode next week. We'll see you then. Bye. Hey everyone, if you can't get enough of us, I would highly recommend subscribing to our podcast, Women in Business and Technology, available right here.
And you can follow us on Twitter and Instagram at our social handles
right here.
Thank you.